Hello and welcome to the GCE Maths Panel on YouTube. And our team consists of certified teachers and makers in statistics and mechanics, further maths, additional maths, and other fields of study. In this particular presentation, we'll be looking at paper 1, June 2019. And we'll answer it in 1/3 the allocated time. Don't forget to subscribe, to share, to watch, and as well comments. You can get to us on the contacts on screen. So we begin this paper. Absolute x plus 1 is strictly less than 2. So this function can be written as x plus 1 less than 2 or x plus 1 greater than minus 2. When we solve, we have x is strictly less than 1 or x is strictly greater than minus 3, and we have our answer to be C, as you can see on the number line. For question number 2, you have, if x is strictly greater than 0, the value of x for which that function is satisfied is. So following the first law of logarithm, the base the same, we multiply to have that. Convert to exponential form, we have 4 to the power 1 equals x into x, 6x plus 10. This becomes a quadratic, and the discriminant of this quadratic is 196, which is b squared minus 4ac. And the value of x will be minus 10 plus or minus. We will leave out the minus because we are interested in the positive value. And when we simplify, we have 1 over 3. So we have B as answer. For this function, the value of f of minus 2 will be, you put minus 2 in the function, you have minus 2 to power 3. Minus 2 times minus 2, simplifying will give us minus 5. Answer C. Question 4. The tangent of the acute angle between the lines y equals 4x minus 3 and y equals x minus 5 is? The gradient of the first line is 4. The gradient of the second line is 1. Gradient is the number in front of x. When y is written in the form y equals mx plus c. So the tangent is given as m1 times m2 over m1 plus m2. When we put the values and simplify, we have 4 on 5. Unfortunately, the answer is not there. Question number 5. The period of the function f of x equals 3 cos 5x. If you have a function of the form a cos bx plus c, the period is given by 2 pi divided by the absolute of b. So here our b is 5, so 2 pi divided by 5 is the period of this function a. To express this number in partial fractions, we have a over the first factor over plus b over the second factor. We multiply all through by x minus 1, x minus 5. We have 2x equals a into x minus 5 plus b into x minus 3. When we compare coefficients using x, you have 2 is equal to a plus b. And for the constants, you have minus 5a is minus 3b equals 0. So we can substitute the first equation into the second. We'll have minus 5 into, instead of writing a, I will write 2 minus b, and simplify, we will have b to be equal to 5 and a minus 3. So our key is b when you put the values on the first equation in the top right. Question number 7. The function f of x is equal to that is continuous in that interval, differentiable on that interval, the value of the constant C, for which f prime of C equals f of 4 minus f of minus 2 divided by that is. So f of 4 in this question gives us 65. F of minus 2 will be minus 7. Our f prime of this function will be 3c squared plus 0. So the 3c squared will be equal to what we have there, 65 minus minus 7 divided by 4 minus minus 2, which is 6, and c squared will be equal to 4, giving us c to be 2. D as answer. Question 8, the arithmetic progression first term ln 2 and common difference ln 4. The sum of the first four terms of this progression would be, for arithmetic progression, the formula for the first n terms is given by that. So we put our values inside to have the first four terms. Our a is ln 2 and our d is ln 4. When we simplify, we'll have 2 into 2 ln 2 plus 3 ln 4. But ln 4 is the same as ln 2 to the power 2, which is 2 ln 2. So I will now have, instead of 3 ln 4, I have 3 times 2 ln 2, which is 6 ln 2. And 2 ln 2 plus 6 ln 2 is 8 ln 2 times 2, 16 ln 2. The key here is B. Question 9, we have x squared plus y squared equals 16x, then the derivative. So this function has two variables. So differentiating 2x, x squared gives 2x. Differentiate y squared to give us 2y, dy dx is equal to 16. We now make 2y dy dx the subject. That will give us 16 minus 2x. And dy dx will be 16 minus 2x divided by 2y. But 2 is common, so we can cancel out 2 to have 8 minus x over y. B is answer. Question 10, the radius of the circle of with equation that is given by. The general form for equation of circle is x squared plus y squared plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equals 0. Here 2g equals minus 10 and g is equal to minus 5. 2f equals 12 and f is 6. C is 41. The radius is g squared plus f squared minus c. And you have minus 5 squared plus 6 squared minus 41, giving us square root of 20, which is 2 root 5. C, 11. So get to us, you can get to the contact on screen, and don't forget to subscribe on YouTube and share and like. Question number 11, a relationship between y equals 2, y minus 2, and y minus 1 is given by y minus 2 equals a, b to the power x minus 1. In the linear relationship between y minus 2 and y, x minus 1, the intercept of the straight line in the axis of log y minus 2 is. So we can write this equation as log y minus 2, taking log of both sides, will be equal to x minus 1 log b plus log a. And the graph of log y minus 2 versus x minus 1 will have a gradient of log a as the intercept. The intercept is log a, as you can see. So this gives us d. Question 12, we have the integral of e to the minus x is, this will be minus e to the minus x from 0 to 1. We have upper limit minus lower limit giving us minus e to the minus 1 plus 1, which is the same as 1 minus e to the minus 1. Okay, question number 13. E to the ln x squared dx. Know that e to the ln x squared is the same, just the same as x squared. So we have the integral of x squared dx to be 1 over 3 x cubed plus k. The key is B. Number 14. The condition for quadratic equation that to be 0 to have two equal roots is, which are real is, condition to have two real roots is the discriminant must be zero. So we have 2k squared minus 4 times a times c, which is greater than or equal to 0. We solve. We have 4k squared minus 4k minus 24 greater than or equal to 0. 4 is common. We will have k squared minus k minus 6 greater than 0. And the root of the equation will be minus 2 and plus 3. But this is an inequality, so we have to test. Let us use 0 to test. The root will lie between minus 2 and plus 3 or outside. So when we test, we see that the only region that satisfies is below minus 2 and above 3 when we use 0 to test. The key is D. Question 15. If cos theta equals 3 on 5 and theta is an acute angle, then the exact value of sine 2 theta is? So cos theta is 3 on 5. Then sine theta will be 4 on 5 from Pythagoras theorem. So sine 2 theta will be 2 times sine theta times cos theta. That is giving us 2 times 4 on 5 times 3 on 5. So we have 24 on 25a. Question 16. If the determinant of this matrix is 0, then we have that m equals 0. So using the first value, we have 1 into 1 times 0 minus x times 0, that is 0. Then the second, we have 1 into 2 times 0 minus 1 times 0, giving us 0 still. And for the third, that is x minus 1 now into 2 times x minus 1. This is what we have. So when we simplify, we have 2x squared minus x minus 2x plus 1 equals 0. And that gives us 2x squared minus 3x plus 1 equals 0. The key is D. For question 17, the argument of this complex number, we have to multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of denominator, which is 1 plus I. So we simplify numerator. We have 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times I is I. So plus I times 1 is I. So that gives us 2 I's. Then I times I is minus 1, all of that divided by 1 times 1, which is 1. And minus I times plus I is also 1. So we have I when we simplify. So tan theta is the same as, note that I is just the same like A plus BI. In this case, our B is 1 and our A is 0. And tan theta is given by B over A. So that gives us 1 over 0, and arctan infinity, because 1 over 0 is infinity, is 90. 90 is the same as pi on 4. That gives us A. Question number 18. The point 3, 0 is on the function f of x, and f prime of 3 is 114. Given x equals 3 is approximate root of equation f of x equals 0. Using Newton-Raphson procedure, a value of second approximation to the root of equation is, for Newton-Raphson, x1 equals x0 minus f of x0 over f prime of 0. And the first root is 3. That would be 3 minus 10 divided by 114. The 10 there is because f of 3 is 10. That gives us 2.91. So the key is C. Number 19, a relation R is defined on the set of real numbers as X relates Y and Y relates X implies X equals Y. So note, if you have just X relating to itself, we talk about reflective. If you have two variables, X relating to Y and Y relating to X, we say it is symmetric. And if we have x relates to y and y relates to x, then x must be equal to y, we say it is anti-symmetric. If you have three variables, we talk of transitive. The only result here that we have is b, it is anti-symmetric. Number 20, a function y satisfies the differential equation x dy dx equals x. If y is 1 when x is 0, then the function can be given by, so we have to separate variables. You have y dy equals x dx. integrate both sides, we have a half y squared equals a half x squared plus a constant. And we put in the values when y is 1 and x is 0, we'll have k to be half. And we replace k by half. Half is common, so we have y squared equals x squared plus 1. The key is a. To get to us, you can get to the contact on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe, to share, to click, like, and comment. Get to us on gcemathspanel@gmail.com or ayao.com. Question 21, you have n combination 2 equals n combination 3. The value of integer n is, so n combination 2 is the same as n factorial over 2 factorial into n minus 2 factorial. That should be equal to n factorial over 2 over 3 factorial into n minus 3 factorial. Simplifying, we'll have 2 into n minus 2, since numerators are the same, equal denominators, will be equal to 6 into n minus 3, because 2 factorial is 2, 3 factorial is 6. So this will give us, like the first one, you have n minus 2 into n minus 3. So that we can have n minus 3 common to both sides. We now cancel out n minus 3 factorial. We have 2 into n minus 2, giving us 6. And our n will be equal to 5. Key is B. Our question number 22. Given x squared minus 4x minus 1 is identical to that, the values of the constants B and C are respectively. Respectively means the first one they call should be the first one you should look for. So B first, then C second. So this is identical. Then the terms in X, you can equate them. That will give us 2B to be minus 4 and B is minus 2. The constant term is B squared plus C. It is not C, it is B squared plus C, giving us minus 1. But we know B is equal to 2, so minus 2 squared is 4. So 4 plus C equals minus 1, and C is minus 5. So the key is D. 23, two functions F and G are such that Fx equals ln x and Gx equals 9 minus x squared. The domain of the composite function Fgx is, so composite function Fgx is ln g of x. That gives us ln 9 minus x squared. And the domain of the function, ln is defined for 9 minus x squared strictly greater than 0. So we factorize, we have 3 minus x, 3 plus x. So we test using the number line. The region that satisfies this is minus 3 less than x less than 3 to be greater than 0. That gives us C. Question 24, the limits of this function, if you put 3 directly, it would not have a limit. So in this case, we can factorize numerator and denominator. Denominator will give us x minus 3, x plus 1. We can now cancel out. You have 1 over 3 plus 1, and that is going to give us 1 over 4. Okay. Now question number 25, this question, it might waste time to simplify, so we can do it by testing. Let us say x, angle x is 45 degrees. You can take any other angle like 90, angles which are fast and the values are known. Let us test in A. If x is 45, the left hand side will give us cos 2 times 45 is 90, that will give us 0. Now put in A, you have sine 0, sine 45 minus cos 45 is also 0. So for A it is true. For B, it is 45, so it is 0. We test in B, you have cos 45 plus sine 45, that is not giving us 1.4, so B is false. For C, you have 0 already. Testing in C, you have 2 cos 45 plus sine 45, that should give us 2.1, so it's false. For D, you test cos 45 minus 2 sine 45 to give us minus 0.7, so it's false. The correct answer here is A. You can do this one by testing. Question number 26. The coefficient of x squared in the binomial expansion is? So you have a equals 2, r equals 2, and we have b to be minus 3x, so n equals 5, n combination r, a to the power r, b to the power n minus r, is the coefficient we are looking for, or the term we are looking for. So this will give us 5 combination 2 times 2 to the power 2 minus 3 to the power 5 minus 2. When we simplify, we'll have 10 times 4 times minus 27, and the answer is minus 1080. That gives us key A. Question number 27. You look at this function, is that when you differentiate the denominator, you have 4x, so it's the same as a half into that function. I'll put a half and multiply the numerator by 2, such that I have balanced. Now, when we integrate, you have a half ln 1 plus 2x squared. From 0 to 2, taking the limit, you have a half into ln 9 minus ln 1. Because 2 times 2 times 2 is 8 plus 1, 9. That gives us ln 9. And when you put 0 into the function, you have ln 1. But ln 1 is 0, so this gives us a half ln 9. A half ln 9 is the same as ln the square root of 9, or ln 9 to the power a half, which is ln 3. Key is D. Question 28. So vectors A and B are given as that and that. The product AB is? So you can use this. The first matrix, the first vector is 1, 2, 1. The second vector is 3, 1, 2. And get the determinant I into 2 times 2 minus 1 times 1 plus j into 1 times 2 minus 3 times 1 plus k into 1 times 1 minus 2 times 3. And you simplify, you have 3i minus, that's plus j, plus 5k, and answer is C. Question 29. The statement P is such that x squared equals 4 and Q is such that x equals 2. The only statement below which is true is, let us start with A. A is not sufficient since minus 2 squared is also equal to 4. So P does not always imply Q. If x squared equals 4, then x can be 2 or minus 2. So 2a is not actually totally true. It is necessary but not sufficient. B, x equals 2 is implied by x squared equals 4 is also partial. C, it is also partial. It is not sufficient enough. And the answer should be D, x squared equals 4 does not necessarily mean x is equal to 2. So we have D as the key. Question number 30. There are 6 black cards and 4 red cards on table. In how many ways can 4 cards be selected from table if the number of colors in the selection must be equal? For the number of selections in the for the number of cards in the selection to be equal means you must have 2 red cards and 2 black cards all the time. So there is no order. So this is a direct combination. For the black, we have to select 2 from 6. So we have 6 combination 2. For the red, we have to select 2 from 4. That gives us 4 combination 2. And there are 6 combination 2 times 4 combination 2 ways. When you simplify, you have 6 combination 2 is 15. And 4 combination 2 is 6. You multiply, you have 90. Our key, our answer is C. You can get to us on screen using the contacts, and you can email us at gcemathpanel@gmail.com. Don't forget to subscribe, click like, share, and comment. Okay, question 31. The equation of the asymptote of this curve is, so since degree of numerator is less than degree of denominator, the horizontal asymptote is 0. For vertical asymptote, you equate denominator to 0 and solve for x. You have x squared minus 4x plus 3 equals 0. So solve this equation. You have this equation most of the time in class. You know that the roots will be x equals 1 and x equals 3. So these are the three asymptotes of the curve, and the answer is C. Question 32, if sine x plus y equals x, then the y the x is. So when you differentiate sine x plus y, you have cos x plus y times, differentiating the core, you have 1 plus dy dx is equal to, right hand side is 1. So you now have 1 plus dy dx equals 1 over cos x plus y. And dy dx will be equal to 1 over cos x plus y plus minus 1. Minus 1. And this will give us 1, that will give us 1 minus cos x plus y all over cos x plus y. So our key, our answer here will be A. Our answer here will be A. Question 33, the relationship between two variables x and y is expressed in the values in the table below using trapezium rule. An approximate value for the integral 2 to 5 of y dx is, trapezium rule is given by h over 2 into f of the first value plus f of the last value times plus 2 times the sum of the rest, where h is b minus a over n. And how do you get your n? I'll give you a simple way. On the table, you have x having values of 2, 3, 4, and 5. So there are 4 values. Your n will be 4, these 4 values minus 1. So your n will be 3. Okay, now your h should be 5 minus 2 divided by this 3, giving you 1. So your approximate integration will be a half into the first y value is 0.692, last y value is 1.609, plus 2 times the remaining values, that is 1 plus 0.099 plus 1.386. Simplify gives you 3.636, and your answer is A. Question number 34, you have z equals 1 plus 2i over 3 minus 4i equals a plus bi. Z will be equal to, for this question, you have to multiply numerator and denominator by the conjugate of denominator, that is 3 plus 4i. For numerator, we have 3, 1 times 3 is 3. 1 times 4i is 4i, 2i times 3 is 6i, and 2i times 4i is minus 8. Divided by denominator, you have 3 times 3, which is 9, plus minus 4i times plus 4i, that gives you plus 16. Remember, the denominator is difference of 2 squares, we just work with the extremes. So finally, this will give you minus 5 plus 10i on 25, but 5 is common. That will give us minus 1 plus 2i on 5. So looking at this, the key will be D. Okay, question 35. The position vectors of point A and B are OA equals that, OB equals that. The equation of the line passing through A and B is. This equation of the line is the vector equation of the line and is given by, I'll use OA plus mu into B minus A. My B, vector B, is minus 2, 4 minus 2, minus A, 2, 1, 4. And I simplify, I'll have mu into minus 2 minus 2 is minus 4, 4 minus 1 is 3, minus 2 minus minus 4 is 2. So the vector equation of this line is C. Question 36. In a class of 25 students, in a class, 25 students offer economics or geography or both. If 12 students offer economics and 17 offer geography, then the number of students offering both subjects is. So it's good to draw a Venn diagram. For economics, you have that, and geography that. Now, at the center is X. We don't know how many students offer both subjects. The total for economics is 17, so the remaining part of the economics, those two, only economics, not both, will be 17 minus the x. will be 12 minus the x, sorry, and those for geography will be 17 minus the x. So the sum of all of these will give us 25 students in the class. So 12 minus x plus x plus 17 minus x will give us 25, and when we solve x, we have 4. We'll do both subjects. So our answer is B. Question number 37. Two independent events A and B are such that probability of A is that probability of B equals that. Find probability of A union B. Since the events are independent, the probability of A and B is given by the product. So this will give us probability of A is 2 on 5. Probability of B is 3 on 7. Probability of A intersection B is probability of A times probability of B. And when you simplify, we will have, you have the LCM of all of these 35 divided by 5 is 7 times 2, 14, plus 35 divided by 7 is 5 times 3, 15, minus 35 divided by 35 is 1, times 6 gives us minus 6. So we have 23 on 35. Our key is D. Question 38. The mean of a set of 6 observations is 6, and the mean of another set of 4 observations is 6. The mean of the combined observation is? We first of all have to have the total of each. The total of the first one is 6 times 4. The total of the second is 4 times 6. The total sum is that, now divided by the total number of observations, which is 6 plus 4. So the new mean will be 4.8. Many students make mistake here. They just take the average of the two mean, which is not correct. So you have to first look for the total for the first, total for the second, and divide by total number of scores. That B is the answer. 39, a DRV follows binomial with parameter 6 and P, where P is probability between 0 and 1. If expectation of X is 18 on 7, find value of P. Know that for binomial distribution, expectation is given by NP. Our N here is 6 and our P is what we are looking for. So 6P is equal to 18 over 7 and P will give us 18 over 7 times 6, which is 3 on 7. C is the key. Question 40. The number of buses arriving a particular bus stop within an hour is 6. Probability no bus arrives at this bus station in half an hour interval is. So f of t for this exponential distribution is lambda e to minus t lambda. The mean is 6. So f of t equals 6 e to minus 6 t. F of half will be 6 e to minus 6 times a half. And that gives us e to minus 3. The probability is e to minus 3. That's the probability. The key is c. You can get to us on YouTube, and don't forget to subscribe, share, comment, and can send us a mail at gcmathspanel@yahoo.com. I am Louisa A, presenting this paper. 41, the probability density function of continuous random variable is that and zero elsewhere. The mean m is, to get the median of probability density function, it is the sum from the median to infinity, because median is midway, the middle value, and the sum of probability density function, the total from negative infinity to positive infinity is 1. So the median will occur at position where it will give us a half. So the median is such that the integral from median to infinity is a half, or the integral from minus infinity to median is a half. It is better for us to use the one from negative infinity to m, since our data here is from 0 to 2, so we work from 0 to median. 0 to median. Don't think the median here is 1, you cannot be sure. So we work from 0 to median. So we have 3x, we are integrating. When you integrate 3 times 4 over 16 gives us 12 on 16x. When we simplify, we have 3x on 4. Then we integrate 3 over 16x squared. So 3 over 16x squared, we integrate, you have minus 3 over 16x cubed times 1 on 3. the minus is in the question here, it's not part of the integration. So I will have minus x cubed on 16. So that is the integral. And here it is faster to use 0 to m, as I've mentioned, than m to 2. So we now have, taking the upper minus lower, you have m 3m over 4 minus m cubed on 16 minus the lower bound is 0. So I'll not bother to put it. All of this should be equal to a half. So you have, multiplying all through by 16, you have 12m minus m cubed equals 8. Bringing everything to right hand side, you have m cubed minus 12m plus 8 equals 0. And the key is A. Question 42. A random variable x follows normal distribution with mean 4 and standard deviation 2. The probability that x lies between 5 and 7 is? So z1 is, you look for the standard value of z. z1 should be 5 minus mean divided by standard deviation. That gives us, that will give us 0.5. And z2 will be 7 minus 4 divided by standard deviation. That gives us 1.5. So is the probability of z lying between 0.5 and 1.5. The key is A. You have converted from x to z, the standard values. Question 43. A factory manager claimed the length of a certain type of rods produced in his factory have a mean of 420 centimeter and standard deviation 12. To test this claim at 5% of significance, a sample of 100 rods was randomly selected and found to have mean length 423 centimeter. The value of the test statistic for this test will be, so the test value will be z is equal to x minus mu all over standard deviation root over root n, where our z here will be 423 minus 420, the claimed mean, divided by standard deviation is 12 over the 100 that was chosen. Simplify gives us 2.50, and the answer is B. Question 44. The summary statistic for the data set such that summation of f equals 18, summation of all the x is 108, and summation of all the x squared is 708. The standard deviation of this distribution is, so standard deviation squared is equal to summation of x squared minus summation of x all squared on n, all that over n minus 1. You have seen this formula in class. So we put in the values, and that's what you will have. When we simplify, you will have 3.5294. And the square root of 3.5294 gives us 1.88. So we take the value to be B. Number 45, a random experiment consists tossing a coin 10 times. The random variable, the number of heads obtained, can be best described by. So here, the probability of head is constant. This is P. The number of times is known, it is N. And find that the probabilities are independent. So the only distribution that is best for this one is the binomial distribution. So X follows binomial with parameter N and P. Question 46. A fair die is rolled once. The score. Given the score is an even number, the probability that it is prime number is. So it is direct. The only prime number that is even is 2. And the probability here is 1 over 6. You can use another way to calculate. The key is D. Question 47. The mean of n numbers is 13. When 27 is added to the numbers, the mean is n of this n plus 1 numbers is 15. The value of n is, so the sum of n plus 1 numbers should be this 13 times n plus the 27. Now we have a total of n plus 1 numbers. So the mean of this n plus 1 numbers should be 13n plus 27 divided by n plus 1, and this should give us 15. We solve for n, multiply both sides by n plus 1, you have 15n plus 15 to be equal to 13n plus 27, and 2n, it will be give us 14n, give us 7. The key not there. Question 48. Two events A and B are such, probability A not occur is 2/3. And probability of B is half, probability of A union B is 3/4. What is the probability of A intersection B? Know that the probability of A intersection B is probability of A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B. And we can write the formula like this. probability of A intersection B will now be that. We now put in the values. Probability of A is 1 over 3. Probability A occurs is 2 over 3. So probability that A does not occur, complementary events, will be 1 over 3. Probability of B is half, and probability A union B is 3 quarters. The LCM is 12 divided by 3, 4, divided by 2, 6, divided by 4 times 3 gives us 9. So our answer will be 1 on 12, and key is D. 49. The standard normal variable Z is such that it follows normal distribution in parameter 0, 1. If probability of Z greater than A is 0.2877, then A must be. So probability of Z greater than A is the same as 1 minus probability of Z less than A, as you know. So it means 0.2877 will be equal to 1 minus probability of Z less than A. Then, probability of Z less than A is 0.7123. So A minus 0 divided by 1, since the standard deviation is 1 and the mean is 0 for normal distribution, should be equal to 0.7123. So for A, you have A to be 0.7123. And the key is B. So for question number 15, in a certain competition, two judges ranked four contestants as shown in the table. Calculate the Spearman's rank correlation for this data. So the Spearman rank correlation is given by 6 summation deviation squared over n into n squared minus 1. The deviation here is the difference of the score. So this will give us 1 minus 6 into 1 minus 1 is 0 squared is 0. 2 minus 4 is minus 2 squared is 4. 3 minus 3 squared is 0. And 4 minus 2 is 2 squared is 4. All over 4 into 16 minus 1. And when you simplify, you have 1 minus 48 on 60, which is equal to 0.20. Thank you so much, and we are going to be putting on paper 2 after this. Don't forget to subscribe, and you can get to us on gcemathpanel@yahoo.com via mail. You can click subscribe and share with other people to have their own A grades. Thank you so much. I have been Louisa A, and watch out for part 2. We have answered the question in 40 minutes, leaving out this other time.